not the right liberal. I don't think the right liberal, although he feels that he's been right close, I don't think that he even has been able to understand this. And especially this idea about the same thing that's been going on in the Muslim movement as well with your small church. I don't even think that he, although he's felt he's been real close.
I don't think he's even suspected it. Because, well, white liberals think of themselves as missionaries. I had a kind of fight once with a fairly well-known white liberal. And I said in the course of my conversation, something about Mr. Charlie. This man has been around for a long, long time. And he said, who's Mr. Charlie? And I was shocked that he didn't know, you know. And I told him who Mr. Charlie was. They said, you're Mr. Charlie. All white men are Mr. Charlie. But liberals have protected themselves against this level of experience because their principal motive so far been, as far as I can tell, a kind of alleviation and a protection of their own consciences. They want to do something to help Negroes because it makes them feel better. But the price that they paid for this kind of effort is that they've never discovered who a Negro is. Not what, but who. Only a liberal, for example, could write the script of the defiant ones. No Negro could. No. Only a liberal can be offended, as John Fisher in Harper's Magazine is offended. When Negroes make some unmistakable indication that they don't want anymore. This is the record, you see. They really think that somehow the record of the Negro people's survival in this country is something on which they can congratulate themselves. And they don't know that